My presentation will start from the groundwater management. Is it technical or social issue? Invisible resource. So it is very difficult to see the groundwater. Second thing is linked with the very complicated science. It's like this five blind men are visualizing elephants. Our scientific community normally works at the larger scale. The scale is never come down to the community level. Of course, we have seen in many planning processes, many development processes, the local knowledge is always ignored. That's why Vishwanath is working on this heritage park. And mostly groundwater management, the current scenario is based on the administrative boundaries. So this is main focus. And if you see the groundwater challenges in this commission, we have institutional challenges, social, policy level, management, and natural level. There are five dimensions where we are facing the challenging, and groundwater management. And the solution lies somewhere. Problem is arising like over-exploitation, salinity increase, quality degradation. And here I think we are saying the technological aspects need to resolve this issue. So I think we can layer out the social part, the global part, and the technical and technology in the lower this land. If you see the major challenges, this groundwater science itself is a challenge for us. You see the groundwater, as I mentioned, groundwater invisible and animal resource, area diversity, geological complexity, technical variables, aquifer diversity, inherent salinity canopy issues. Specific issues of the specific area needs local specific strategies. That is, we are trying to resolve making a strategy very generalized. They are seeing this groundwater quantification is a very difficult task at a community level. Of course, the mismatching of the aquifer, political, basin or watershed boundaries. Then we talk about the management. Social challenges, you see the lack of awareness. People are normally not understanding the importance of the groundwater. They just see saying that the groundwater is an unlimited source, let's use it. This kind of attitude and basic understanding on groundwater science almost nil in the community. Aquifer, groundwater movement, discharge ratio, etc. All are the aspects which normally lacking in the community or the stakeholders. Always we are seeing that the victims or the victims of the groundwater exploited areas, groundwater degraded quality areas are not a part of the planning process. Another issue is inadequate human resource development. If you see the groundwater subject starts in the second year of the BSc. We have never seen this groundwater subject at the lower in the lower education system like primary or secondary system. So this doesn't attract the students for the groundwater management in the future. Conflict between different users, this domestic agriculture industry, other conflict between different areas, rural, urban, peri-urban, this kind of the challenges are the social. Institutional challenges are also there. I think Manchuji will talk more in this. But even in this macro level understanding, a policy maker and planner level, planning level, we always miss this part and we think about the district level and the block level, but we are never thinking for the village level or the local level. Proper institutional structure, we are not saying that there are hierarchy, central groundwater board, state level groundwater board, but as we come in the closer the district and then block level, this entire layer is missing. Again, there are many departments are using the groundwater, like irrigation department, agriculture department, many departments are working on the groundwater, but the horizontal linkages is always missing there. Almost negligible involvement of the stakeholders in water resource management, especially in decision making, the technical decision taken politically. As Tushar bhai you correctly mentioned, also one of the this slide, I think he has explained the whole vicious cycle of the groundwater exploitation. And I think here there are two things we can see. One is that the farmers' strength. If we can educate this group of the farmer, then this cycle may be reversed. That is one opportunity area where we can do the capacity building. Mani was also explaining this. I will go back to more slides. Policy level, then I will not talk more about this because there are many people who can discuss about this. Then how we involve the community in the groundwater management. I will explain this thing by explaining the three case studies. One is in urban area where we are working on the educating the community for water resource management, and two more case studies. One where we are working in the river basin management level, and one is aquifer management level. In Bhuj, we have one very heritage lake, and which is a very good resource for the groundwater recharge for entire city. So we have started the educating the community, the different kind. You can see the school children are there, some women and other citizens are there, youngsters are there, school students are there. We have arranged one education trip, and regularly we bring the group of the citizens, different kinds of the citizens, and we show all the geohydrological characteristic of a lake and how this lake is useful resource for groundwater recharge, and through the groundwater, how it is important for our city level drinking water. So we have started this awareness through the educating the community by different means, by making the presentation, and in the exposures. Then awareness campaign. We are using the opportunity to explain our ideas through the Janmashtami phase was there. So there was an awareness there. You can see this is the MP who also visited. So targeting the different kind of the people, different level of the people for the education. Again, organizing citizens workshop to understand, to explain how these systems are important for us, the mass awareness. Then people are taking course also in the area level slideshow. Then also educating the children, school children, from the beginning, so that we can invest our knowledge system into the future generation. And through these school children, the parents, we can educate the parents also. Information sharing, different kind of information with different kind of the community. And after some time, we organized one big event in the city level, and where we have involved, like this person is the collector, district collector of that of the goods. Then different cities, and we organized one participatory implementation program to clean the some part of the lake. All are the stakeholders which are located in the different part of the watershed. So it was important to get together all the stakeholders at one place and to explain how their location is important for management of this particular resource. Then media also has the very good role. This was the one event. This is the one event where we organize a community and we educate the community for the groundwater management part. And later on, this community is constituted of one citizens committee, which we call it Jal Strot Sneh Samvardhan Samiti. And that samiti is playing a role of the pressure group, as the farmer has played the pressure group for the electric subsidy, etc. So this is the group. Now it has this group has enough knowledge about the whole system, and they are making the pressure on the municipality administration, and they are also pressurizing the system to develop some of the area or to preserve or to conserve or to protect the groundwater resource. And this was the one case where we have educated the citizen level committee, community, and this is another part where you are seeing this one of the boy is making some calculation and with the map. This is the whole concept of barefoot geohydrologist. I think as I mentioned earlier that the education system considers this geohydrology from the second year of the BSc. So we are trying to pull this education system at the lower level, at the village level. So this is the one concept where barefoot geohydrologist comes in the picture, and there we are trying to fill the gap between this scientific community and the decision-making community or the stakeholders. For this, we are developing different kind of the education material or the hydrological knowledge system in a very simplified form, so that they can easily understand the science, hydrological science, and they can utilize this knowledge system for the decision making as well as the groundwater management. Like you can see the informal science and formal science, we are developing this kind of the tools. So we are trying to reduce the gap between the science, formal science and informal science, and we are using this as a education or the training material for the barefoot workers. And based on whole understanding, scientific understanding as well as the traditional understanding, making a simplified matrix of the development strategy, based on this kind of the matrix, the barefoot worker can facilitate the village management institution or the citizens management institution to take a decision or to manage their own resources and planning as well as the management. This is another case example where we are involving the various stakeholders in the aquifer management planning. You can see we are working on this part currently. So this is another demonstration phase. We have designed a first phase for the planning where we have divided up different activities in under the awareness and capacity building. And even within that category, we have defined the three stages. The first phase where the organization, and this, you see the word Parab. Parab is an interesting word. This is a small unit working at a block level and totally run by the barefoot workers. So they are playing a very good barefoot technologist role in all planning process of this shared aquifer system. This is an aquifer which is having about 70 to 75 villages. They are sharing the one aquifer. So in this kind of the situation, the organization like SET, which is also working as a knowledge research center, which is having the scientific knowledge system, and the Parab is a barefoot level geologist work group. So these two units activity is to identify a local leadership, local level, the traditional knowledge, rural experts, and then with the help of the, you see, and the third level, SET, Parab and rural expert. So gradually we are identifying the leadership and involving this community for the planning process, and then finally you see ACT, Parab, rural expert and the village committee. And with the help of this barefoot workers and rural expert, we are trying to develop a cluster level village committee, and that committee is going to play a role of the groundwater management at decentralized level. So this is the one level of the activity, awareness and capacity building. Simultaneously, we are also doing the study and research. Here the major actors are the Parab, and the barefoot workers are doing this research, and they are regularly feeding this knowledge to the rural expert and the village committee. And the third phase is the planning, where the decision making tools will be developed for the aquifer management. And if you see the upper corner, there is a technical advisory team, and here the advocacy and sharing of learning. this two team has the very important role. Because this technical advisory team, we are thinking of person like Tushar Bhai and other academicians, other policy makers. So they are regularly advise this kind of the effort, this kind of the initiative, and this experience they can take at the higher level. And here, through the advocacy and sharing of learning, we can expand this kind of the activities to the different kind of the stakeholders in different areas, different aquifer. And of course, the second phase will be more focused on the implementation part. This is another example where we are doing this social engineering based on the natural resource boundaries. We are working in one of the river basin. And that river basin has different kind of the clusters where they have different groundwater and arid region or lakefront area. So we have divided the whole basin and the clusterized the villages based on the water characteristic. And based on this, we are trying to demonstrate this kind of the model. Here you see the upper is the Rukmavati Basin Level Federation, but this Mahajan is a technical word. And the, traditionally, the Mahajan people are the managers of, and are the conflict resolver among the society. So we are build, we are concentrating this Mahajan at the cluster level, and each and every Mahajan are looking at one of the problem, particular problem of their cluster. And below this Mahajan, this village level committees, and within village level committee, the user group. You see the technical service. Here the parameters are also the key factors which are linking all efforts from the user group to basin federation level. The basin federation level, in this particular case, we have formed one company, producers company, which is looking after all basin resource management. So here we can see the different stakeholders, different decision makers, and the role of technical services of the para worker. All these para workers are of the local areas. Similarly, margins are also from the local areas. And to manage the natural resources, considering they all different kind of the diversity, technical diversity, and the natural cycle. So if we do, then we can promise ourselves or the society to take the responsibility of this kind of the precious natural resources.